What's up, guys? Back on the Undertow album grind. Obviously, I'm slowing down the pace a little bit just because I don't want to lose out on you Tool fans, because the support has been just crazy, guys. I'm humbled by the support that I've gotten on all the Tool videos so far. Like, we've done, I think on the Tool playlist we have like 40 reactions done now, and some of them videos have like more than one track on that, so it's over 40 tracks I've reacted to. Didn't really think I'd get this far. I know I told myself I would do their whole discography, and I figured like I'd probably find an album somewhere in there that made me just like be like, fuck this, I'm not doing it anymore. But I'm still yet to find that. Now, I will admit that Undertow hasn't been my favorite of their albums thus far, nor was Opiate. So we've kind of gone two back to back where I haven't like thoroughly enjoyed. There's still been small sections of each album that I have enjoyed, but I really do like their more recent music. Just that slightly better production value makes all the difference with their music. Don't get me wrong, some of their music is like, a lot of their music is timeless, but just from my point of view, because I've come from listening to Fear Inoculum, I'm working backwards, it's always going to be hard to find tracks that impress me as much as their newer tracks. But obviously, we still want to go through the whole discography. That's the point of doing this. It's still just seeing where they've come from. So that is what we're going to be doing today, guys. We have Crawl Away. Again, we've got the audio version because it's very hard to find a lyric video that also has good audio on YouTube. So I'm going to have the lyrics on my own screen. And then if you guys want to pull up the lyrics, or even just if you know the lyrics, then either way, you can do whatever you want, guys. All you gotta know is that I'll have the best quality audio in my ears, as well as the best quality lyrics, I hope, from Genius on screen. And then we will talk about the track after. Obviously, we're not gonna do any pausing unless there's anything extremely significant that needs to be said throughout. We wanna just take in the music as we always do with Tool and enjoy the rest of this journey. So guys, please do drop a like. You guys smashed it on the last video. I asked for people to pick it up with the likes because we dropped off a little bit and you guys did just that. So if you wouldn't mind again, I feel like I don't need to ask, but sometimes asking does just help. Great to get some interaction from you lot, but I'm gonna shut up now. Let's go. Christmas song. Christmas. This sounds like a Christmas song. Happy Christmas, by the way, guys. It's the 21st of December as I'm recording this. I'm finished work on Monday. It's now Saturday. So I'll be able to get a good few videos out for you. That bass is fucking ridiculous. Thank you. Oh my god, Adam Jones, you sick animal. Here, Justin Chancellor is getting a lot of credit, and he's, don't get me wrong, he's amazing, but Paul DeMore, he's holding his fucking own. Right on cue. Alright, well, there's just a sense of, like, I don't know what it is, it's like tool timing. I refer to COD timing a lot. Me and my friends play COD, alright, Call of Duty. You probably know already, because if you've been watching this channel, but I'm a big Call of Duty fan, and there's a thing called Call of Duty timing, alright. So, example, quick analogy is, when you're aiming down a corridor waiting for someone, Call of Duty timing is essentially when you've been aiming down this corridor, waiting for someone to run out for 20 seconds, which is a long time in Call of Duty. And the second you decide, right, there's no one that's going to come down this corridor, the second you decide to look somewhere else, the person comes down that corridor. And that is what we call Call of Duty timing. It just happens so frequently that it's actually a thing in COD, okay? Now, to move on to the point that I actually wanted to make was tool timing, okay? Now, every time I, like, say something about maybe not enjoying a tool track or maybe not enjoying a tool album and then jumping into another reaction, the song always blows my fucking head off. And that is a perfect example of this once again. Crawl Away was one that you guys did say was gonna be very good. After I did Bottom, which I did enjoy a little bit more off of I can't remember the name of the album, the Undertow album. I didn't enjoy the first few tracks as much as I had been, and then Bottom came along, I was like, okay, this is good. And now people were saying that once you get to Bottom, the tracks are all kind of like very Tool-esque from that point onwards. So maybe we're turning the corner a little bit on Undertow album, and maybe we'll start to enjoy a little bit more, because that was like listening to one of the newer tracks. That's what it felt like, because I felt like my last few reactions have been a bit stale. I haven't really just been like doing much. I've just been like sitting there and like listening to the track for the sake of listening to the track. But this one definitely felt like the experience that I've had with a lot of their other tracks. So yeah, that one was an instant classic with me. Really enjoyed it. And the kind of premise of the song seems to be based around the fact that I don't know if Maynard's speaking from his own point of view, but it's almost as if like he's losing someone in a relationship, and he's like, his way of loving someone is just being basically, I have it written here, it's Crawl Away is a song about controlling narcissist who loses a person close to them, presumably a significant other, so maybe like in a relationship, blah blah blah. So you can see from some of the lyrics there, crawled away from me, slipped away from me, tried to keep a hold. So this is Maynard, or whoever is he's speaking from their point of view, losing a girlfriend or boyfriend or whatever, but there was nothing I could say, so you're just losing, you're fighting a losing battle here. Slid away from me, crept away from me, tried to keep you down, but there's nothing I could say. And then he goes on to kind of like say, your back is turning, if I could, I could stick a knife in you. So because they've already gone away, he can't even get that knife in the back. So it's just a weird kind of outlook on the relationship, which he seems to kind of speak about in a lot of tracks, like weird relationship things. So yeah, no, honestly guys, like usual, I don't really give a fuck about the lyrics at this point. And the lyrics are really something that I'm just going to delve into in my own time when I'm listening to it. I can pick up on the small little parts and maybe just make interpretation of the track that I wouldn't have when I first listened to it. So it's not really that important, it's more so just getting a feel for this song, and I know for a fact I will be returning to this one, guys. So that's gonna be me for the video. I'm blabbing on. Drop the video a like if you could, guys, that'd be great. Sub to the channel if you have not already, and yeah, I'm signing out. Take it easy. Cheers.